the New York Aquarium. How are you all doing today? All right, there is a lot of you out there. I'm sure you can do much better than that. Are you ready to be a sea lion? Like it. Welcome to the Aquatheater and our Sea Lion Celebration. My name is Andy. It'll be my pleasure today to introduce you to our California Sea Lions and their trainers. Now, sea lions are a part of a complex web of life. Today, we're going to be talking about this web as well as how you guys get into it. And speaking of sea lions, not a warm welcome for our California Sea Lion, Otis, and his trainer, Martha. Is 16 years old and he weighs over 400 pounds. Otis is born at an aquarium, so his wild relatives can be found living up and down the Pacific coast. Now, sea lions are very social animals and can be found living in large groups called rookeries. Now, rookeries can be pretty noisy places. Sounds like Otis will use this vocalization to announce and defend their territory. Females, on the other hand, will vocalize to identify their pups on cloudy beaches. The mom will vocalize. And the pup, wherever it may be, will return her call. Now, another way sea lions identify one another is through a behavior called a breath exchange. This looks an awful lot like a sea lion kiss.
Oh,
it looks like our sea lion Osborne over there in the center section is going to try and identify some audience members. And so is Otis over here on the right side. If you would like to identify from Otis or Osborne,
so
please keep your hands behind your back. Lean your cheek way over that front railing, and they'll come right on over and give you a big kiss. There you go. Make sure you lean way on over so we can see that you would like to receive a kiss from Otis or Osborne. There you go. Remember, keep your hands behind your back. Do not reach over to try and touch him. Just look at us both and circle board. Keep real, show more height. There we go. Please lean all the way over. That's it. Don't be shy now.
Falando várias línguas.
Hands behind your back. Don't forget. That's it.
Viu? Ela falando várias línguas.
Lean way on over. There we go. Bend down, bend down. There we go, a couple more.
Agora é assim,
aqui. A couple more. And there you have it, everybody. Just a few kissy kisses, courtesy of Otis and Osborne. The Walruses, the Sea Shield, and the Ear Seal. Now, I know everybody here knows what a walrus looks like, but some people have a hard time telling the difference between Sea Shield and Ear Seal, so let me give you some hints. First, take a look at the sides of their head. If you see an external ear flap, then it's an ear seal just like our sea lions are. Ear seals also have long, strong front flippers, which they use to pull themselves through the water, just like we do with our arms when we go swimming. Now their hind flippers are used for steering in the water, but as you can see, can rotate underneath your body so they can walk on all fours. That just makes them extremely mobile on land, which is... Hey, what's going on? Thank you. right, you guys. That was a wonderful demonstration. But let's move on now, all right? True seals, on the other hand, have much shorter front flippers. And their hind flippers can't rotate underneath their body, so when they come up on land to walk, they sort of have to crawl. Like a caterpillar. Or an inchworm. In the water, sea lions are fast and agile. And, take a look at this really quick, they have very flexible necks. Now this is a great adaptation to help them catch all of the fast-moving fish that makes up their diet. Now, all of these traits make sea lions superb predators. But you know, they don't always play the role of the hunter. Sometimes they're the prey, and there's another animal out there prowling these waters, stalking quarries, just waiting for the right moment to strike. The sea lion is a primary predator. Otis, relax! That was just Osborne having a little bit of fun. But Osborne, this isn't something we should be joking about right now, because sharks are in serious trouble. Due to overfishing, many populations of sharks have decreased by as much as 80%. And as a result, they soon die out, which is hey! Okay, I can see how sharks dying out probably sounds pretty good to a sea lion. But in the long run, this isn't good for any of us. I mean, when the number of shark populations fall, nature's balance is upset and the entire food chain is threatened. Aww. Yeah, so you see, you guys, strange as it sounds, we need sharks. In fact, all species rely on one another in order to survive. In the wild, sea lions spend a large portion of their time avoiding predators like sharks and chasing after prey. They use a method of swimming called porpoising, where they will leap out of the water, take a deep breath, dive back in, and continue on with their forward momentum. Now, using this method, sea lions can reach speeds faster than 15 miles an hour, which is great physical exercise.